Agilent SLIMS version 6.8 brings updates that facilitate building analytical tests and specifications faster and enhance their configuration. Imagine creating one generic test to find the presence of many chemicals and metals instead of generating a test for each specific analyte with the right unit. Well, let's see how it works. The analytical workflow for this demo shows how to use analytes, use result blocks, view specification type messages, use form blocks, fill a locked simplified protocol, complete generic tests for analytes, and use a sum. Analytes are easier to create than tests because they are so simple. You can categorize analytes into multiple groups, like how atrazine is in chemicals and pesticides. This comes into play when you request the specifications to measure in an order. Our water quality federal product has a specification that uses each analyte. You could already link content without a product to an order and assign the product there, but now you can add multiple subproducts in addition. This allows you to request specifications from the product and all subproducts, and they'll all be added to the order. We'll add a request for the indicators of general water quality and a request for the presence of chemicals and metals. Many of the analytes we saw earlier will be measured by just one general concentration test that has choice of unit. The specifications link the analyte and the test and make it requestable. This analytical workflow was created using simplified protocols, which are easy to navigate and use. The configuration of this protocol has left its blocks freely editable by the user in case information needs to be changed, added, or removed during the run's progression. Results can be collected in a results block in 6.8, which is a block that requires a link content block. Here, we're using the workflow's select content from queue step so that any content in the protocol run from the order is linked to this block. This block was set up to request 3 results for pH and a minimum aggregated result over those 3, as well as hardness, turbidity, total dissolved solids, and coliform. These were all automatically created for each of the linked content according to the product specifications. Let's see what feedback we get for some results. You can use applicable fields in a specification to create a secondary test result value next to the first. In this case, we're using a custom field called source for the applicable field. It's been left empty and is triggering an error on validation. If we change the value to an undrinkable source of water, we'll get a different error according to the specification's design. Minimum aggregated results were added with this release to take the lowest value and provide feedback based on the specification. There's also a maximum aggregation method that does just the opposite. There are some custom messages added to rule evaluations when you use specification types. You can choose a feedback type, warning or error, and design the text that's provided when the result is within specification, too high, too low, or not expected. Then a specification can use any of the created specification types. In this case, it's a warning that offers advice about what water hardness is generally considered comfortable. A warning allows the result status to be promoted without validation by the reviewer. The coliform result has a custom error as well, which uses a different specification type. In this case, we're calling attention to a contaminant that could be threatening in high amounts. An error requires the result to be validated by the reviewer. Besides result blocks, a form block can now be used in simplified protocols. Any custom fields you create on the protocol run step table will show up on the form. You can restrict the fields to particular protocol run steps, though, so they'll only show up on particular forms. The contaminants protocol is locked by comparison to the indicators protocol. We want the user to go through the run from top to bottom, so it isn't possible to add, rename, copy, or drag blocks around. The blocks also cannot be removed due to a restriction at the block level. This note block has also been made read-only to provide instructions. More results are being imported on this protocol than the first one. Since all the analytes we're measuring use the same generic test, we allowed choice of unit within the same dimension on the test. There's some feedback on the results that were imported. On lead and on nitrates, the error indicates that these are risky contaminants in high concentration. The specifications for both analytes use the same specification type as the coliform specification we saw earlier. Then, there's a custom warning on iron that lets the user know when the result is below the limit of detection. Since it's informational, it doesn't need to be an error. There is another aggregation method added to this release called SUM. It adds the other results for the selected test and provides the defined feedback based on the specification. We've used it to add the unknown impurities and provide an error if there are too many of them. Just like before, the results can be viewed in the completed order, and the warnings and errors can be acknowledged by the reviewer. Thank you for sticking through the whole video of changes to better support analytical testing in SLIMS. You can see future tutorials, highlights, and news on our YouTube channel, and check out our website for further product information.